What's up, everybody? Welcome back to our video. Hope y'all have an amazing day as usual. Or que lo que, as I should say, because we're having Dominican food today. Anyways, so we're in today's video. Please make sure to like, subscribe, and always comment down below. It really, really helps out the video. So today we're going to be reviewing some Dominican food at a restaurant called Mr. Exquisito, or something like that, in Bloomfield, New Jersey. So I've been moving more towards, rather than snack and beverage reviews, more towards local restaurants, instead of just fast food and snacks and stuff like that, which is good. Since the new year, I'm like, I should promote local businesses in the area. This one I've never been to before. So we're trying Dominican food. I've had Mofongo. That's really the only Dominican food I've ever had in my life. But today we're gonna get more of an experience. Here we have, for an appetizer, we got some empanadas right here. These are empanadas de pollo, or chicken empanadas, and you can tell that these are fried as you look at them. Some countries make their empanadas different. I know that in South America they usually fry them, and I think in Mexico they bake them. I could be wrong, but I know most of the empanadas I've had in my life have been baked, but I know for sure that other places fry them. So let's try it. Very good. The chicken flavor is really good in here. Wow. I'm gonna try it in the sauce. There's two sauces. One is like a spicy mayo, or like some kind of aioli. Maybe it's like a smoky, like paprika. Very good. Let's break off the other one. This might be like a spicy one right here. Yeah, a little bit of heat. Dominican food's not spicy. It's not like, really, no, everyone thinks like, oh, Spanish food is so spicy, but no. Really only Mexico. And like some places have, they do have spice, but not that much. But I know in like Mexico, they're really heavy on like peppers and stuff like that. But in Dominican Republic, no, they don't do spicy, like spicy food that much. I like the this one better, the aioli. I'm hoping that this music does not get me copyrighted. I love some Dominican bachata, but almost any time I do a food review at a restaurant or anywhere in public, I wind up getting copyrighted because of the music in the background. I'm not gonna ask them to turn it down though. What do I look like? Not someone who's important. Yeah. My only complaint, it's really good, but there's not enough meat in here. But yeah, pretty good. I give these a 4.5 out of 10. I mean five, not four. 4.5 out of 5, and then probably a 9 out of 10. Really good. All right, guys. 45 minutes later. It's been a really long wait. Here's our food. Looks pretty good. Here, let me just... It's like that. It looks pretty good. Hopefully, it's worth the wait. I'm sure it will be. I don't mind waiting for good food. Beautiful presentation. I got the mofongo de pollo, which is mofongo, which if you don't know what mofongo is, you're missing out. It's like fried or boiled green plantains that they mash up with chicken broth, garlic, and chicharrones, which are pork rinds, and they basically mush it into a ball, and then you serve it with like a meat, and you definitely put like a gravy on it or something. This one comes in some kind of like a orange sauce. This is what ours looks like. Sauce is really good. Let's try the chicken right here. Chicken is really good. Sauce is very flavorful. The chicken is nice and juicy. And I gotta say, the presentation is beautiful. Like, if I were to show you this to someone and you ask them how much it was, I would probably say like $50. It's $20, but well worth it. Wow. Mofongo can be dry, so that's why it's served with like a gravy or a chimichurri or something like that. So that makes it taste even better. Alright, so do I recommend you try Mr. Exquisito? I do, for sure. Yeah, if you're in the Bloomfield area, it's located right across the street from the CVS and right around Nevada Diner and Angelo's and Quick Check, so you know where that is. Muy bien. I said this stuff's really good. Yeah, my Spanish skills aren't too bad. I only know a little bit of Spanish. I don't speak fluently, but I can ask for like directions, or I can tell someone directions or something like that, or greet someone, or have like a 1 minute conversation. That's about it. But yeah, I learned Spanish from school, so everyone knows what muy bien is, though. Come on. Not that impressive. Our server hardly speaks English, so that's why I was like, alright, muy bien. I was speaking English to him the whole time. Anyways, that's gonna finish today's video. Hope you guys enjoyed. That guy might actually be the owner, because he was standing around kind of observing things, so he might have been the owner. Not sure, but that's gonna be for today's video. Make sure to like, subscribe, and God bless all you guys.